Your six sports report.
Good evening. We'll get to all of today's basketball in just a moment, but potentially serious injury news for the Pittsburgh Penguins. Pens forward Evgeny Malkin is experiencing concussion-like symptoms, including headaches and disorientation after crashing into the boards in last night's win over Florida. This according to the Tribune Review's Rob Rossi. Malkin has been ruled out for tomorrow night's game. NFL Combine going strong right now in Indianapolis. Penn State center Matt Stankiewicz had his workout today. Other Nittany Lions will have their workouts tomorrow. Michael Mowdy will be the interesting one to watch, though. He's still coming back from his season-ending knee injury, but said he's garnered a lot of interest from NFL teams. The unquestioned leader in Penn State's team this past season says Bill O'Brien helped him get ready for the NFL.
Really, more than I could ever have imagined what I learned from him, just about how things work in the NFL, how really a pro offense works in different scenarios, different situations, how to play against defense in different games and stuff like that.
Huge basketball day starting in Quad A with State College and Hollidaysburg District 6 playoffs. Little Lions on a big run early. Kyle Kanaski to Jason Costa, 12-point State College lead. Hollidaysburg's Zach Ottaway keeping the Tigers close. Gets the foul underneath. That cut it under double digits, but the second half was all about Kanaski. Hits the three-pointer there, and then State College swinging it around. Kanaski, another three-pointer, a 16-point lead. He had 21. Little Lions roll 55-29. The second seed in girls Quad A, Altoona girls taking on State College in the semifinals. Tight game first half. State High's Kyla Irwin showing off her pretty post moves. Altoona's Kayla Grime says, don't forget about me. She had a big first half, and Altoona fans would like this as well. Casey Reffner stops and pops for three. Altoona wins 59-55. Other semifinal girls Quad A, two-loss Hollidaysburg facing Mifflin County. Tight game in the second. Hannah Mercer knocks in three of her team-high 13 points, a 9-point Hollidaysburg lead. Then Susie Hellas picks off the Huskies. Pass goes in all the way. Hollidaysburg led by 14 at the half. Morgan Jennings in the second half. She had 12. Hollidaysburg wins 54-43. It hasn't been a pretty season for the St. Francis men's basketball team, but they are coming on strong at the end. After starting the season 0-11, the Flash have reeled off three wins in their last six games. Today on Senior Day, a thriller against Monmouth. Last time these two teams will meet in the same conference, Monmouth going to the Mid-Atlantic Conference. Earl Brown here to Dominique Major in the corner. Flash go up 63-59 late. Monmouth got it back down to two. Then with a minute 30 to play, Ben Melu Minier has ice in his veins. Flash go back up five. Monmouth, though, storms back, and Jesse Steele was so clutch late in this game. He hits the three from the corner, make it a two-point game after trading baskets. Now 8 seconds to go. The Flash up two. Steele, three-pointer for the win, off the mark, the rebound and tie, also no good. St. Francis wins 70-68. UPJ men also on Senior Day, needing to win to host a playoff game Tuesday. High scoring first half, thanks to senior Nick Novak. He had 35 points today. Then it's Matt Palo with a beauty of a dish to Ian Vescovi. Highlander throwdown. Tight game throughout the first half. Nate Perry here. Excuse me, this is Oliver McGlade for three. He's talking trash, and Seton Hill wins 86-80. Daytona 500 coming up tomorrow. The nationwide race was today, and a horrific 12-car crash at the finish. Tony Stewart got the checkered flag, but that was secondary because Kyle Larson's car was sent airborne. The front half of the car was torn off because of the fencing. Six spectators were taken to the hospital with serious injuries. That's all we have on their status right now. Of course, the Daytona 500 is tomorrow. Make sure you're back with us tonight at 11 for all of tonight's high school basketball and wrestling championships. 6 News will be right back.